suggestion that our next guests are TV game show greats. Let's welcome Tony Barber, yeah. Don Burgess and Greg Evans to Studio 10.
You know, on the show.
Right?
Yes.
The three kings.
Okay. Oh, he is.
Three wise monkeys. Wow.
That was a
three wise men.
Hello, Ida.
Hello, how are you?
Hi, everyone. Well. Can I please just say I've been in that very sumptuous hotel room watching the whole morning. It's really is compulsory viewing.
Oh.
It's just been fabulous.
Thank you. Thank you.
And it can only get better.
That's right. The cream has arrived.
Right, because of legends like you.
Yeah, amazing. Coming from you, you've actually hosted 8,000 game shows.
Wow.
Episodes of game shows. You were the salesman of the century.
Well, I think we were all special in our own ways, but I couldn't help thinking in the green room. With, you know, Greg here being a marriage celebrant and the plebiscite coming up, if you're a better sort, we could, you know, but...
Oh, well, wait a minute.
We were never that close.
Wait a minute.
I'd vote yes to that.
Being the youngest one here...
See, you'd never pick that.
Listen, you said one of your biggest regrets was taking over from Baby John.
Yes. You couldn't. You shouldn't have been... Tried, attempted, but they were stuck because you just, you know, you left. I'll never forget, you know, after a couple of weeks of disastrous thing.
But was it difficult for you? Was it a hard time?
Oh, it was just shocking. After a couple of disastrous weeks of ratings, I got called into the Supremo's office and they said, look, it's all right. We've done a survey, you know, we've done research, what's happened is people thought that Burjo and Ariadne were a couple, and you've broken them up.
Wow. That's Adriana, you mean?
I mean, yeah.
Burjo, was it a hard time?
I'm not sure who he was.
Was it a hard time for you, Bep? Was it a hard time for you?
Well, it was. I got a phone call to say that they're replacing me as host of Wheel of Fortune. It was in June 1996, which was a bit of a shock, I've got to say. Mm.
They're always fairly blunt, aren't they?
12 years, yeah.
They've done it for 12 years.
Oh. Always such wise decisions too, aren't they?
Yeah, well, yeah. A couple of like Gary Rice and Alan Bateman, I love mentioning their names because no one knows where they are.
And you are still here looking marvellous.
I'm still here.
I got the next phone call that said, we want you to do it. And I said, I could never do that. That's Burgess. I could never do that. And they said, we're paying. And I said, I could try. Really?
So, how much was it, dare I say?
Oh, it was, you know.
Millions?
No, we don't talk money. You know.
The interesting thing was that was in June 96, they got rid of me. In November 1996, they offered me my job back. And I can tell you, it was three times, because I was employed by Grundy's, by the 7-Eleven, but they offered me three times the money. But then I went to another channel. Ended up doing Catchphrase, which then knocked everybody off again at 5:30 for the next 8 years.
Yeah.
So you can't keep the good man down. If anybody's watching, I'm still here.
Did you have a favourite moment?
Everybody's watching.
No, well, you know, the people who signed that check.
And Greg, your show, Perfect Match, I mean, I remember that was just compulsory viewing when I was a kid. How was it being, you know, the love doctor of Australia?
The love god in the newspaper the other day. Joe, it was fantastic. We always had fun making the show. And everybody in the studio, I was always of the impression that if you had fun making it, it was easy to transmit that fun up the stick and people would enjoy watching it. And I think we had 11 marriages. And,
11?
Yeah, there was one baby and about three murders.
Is that why you became a marriage celebrant?
Do you know, I would never have guessed while I was actually hosting Perfect Match and introducing strangers that one day I would be marrying love couples.
You do it for real.
Yeah. Still the love guru.
Did you do that as well?
What?
No.
A marriage celebrant?
Oh, no. Hello.
You're getting him confused.
I'm glad I kept my own together.
Are you still doing your fabulous bowling? Because I remember when we last saw you, you were teaching us some bowling moves.
I think you beat me though that day, so I'm still not talking to you.
No.
I just if the plebiscite gets up and you were a better sort, we could be a perfect match.
He's got a thing about this.
It's perfect. Unbelievable. Oh. I'd let that one go, wouldn't
you? How lucky have we been to have you three blokes on our couch this morning. Thank you so much.
Thank you for entertaining
us over the years. We're back in a moment with some more of the Studio 10 celebrating 60 years of telly.